Thank you everybody for joining Living Spanish. Sorry for being a little late. I was trying to set everything to get everything ready for class. Thank you so much for joining Living Spanish. We're going to start in about 10 minutes when we have a little crowd to start. Muchas gracias por unirse a Living Spanish. If you're here for the lesson, let me know in the live chat, okay? Say hi so I know that you're here. Before we start the class in 10 minutes, I'm going to explain a little bit how this class works. And if you live in Spanish, no worries. I can explain you how everything works. Paul, hola. Really nice to have you here. How's the weather in Plimpton? ¿Cómo está el clima en Plimpton? Thank you to all the people that are joining. Gracias a todas las personas que se están uniendo. Sorry that I'm a little late. I was trying to get everything ready for this class. Topic of today, Day of the Dead, Día de Muertos. This is a holiday is coming really soon here in Latin America. Luna, hola, really nice to have you here. Welcome to Living in Spanish. Getting colder, 58. Oh, yeah, it's getting chilly. The fall is here. Here in Quito is actually really, really sunny today. Not too common for a Sunday. El clima en Quito está haciendo un poco de calor, mucho sol, pocas nubes. ¿Cómo está el clima en Quito? Thank you to all the people that are joining to this class. If you're here for the lesson, let me know in the live chat. We're going to start in 10 minutes when we have a little crowd to start. Gracias a todas las personas que se están uniendo. Si estás aquí para la clase en vivo, déjame saber en el chat. Vamos a comenzar dentro de 10 minutos cuando tengamos un poco de gente para comenzar. No te olvides de darle like, suscribirte y compartirlo con tus amigos, compañeros y familiares. Everybody is really welcome in Living Spanish. Todos son bienvenidos en Living Spanish. Don't forget to follow me in Instagram, Twitter, Facebook as Living Spanish. I guess you have the links in the description of this video. Topic of today, Día de Muertos. Connie, hola. Really nice to have you here today. How is the weather in Germany? ¿Cómo está el clima en Alemania? Está lloviendo. Uf. Lo bueno, it's good that you have a Spanish class. Lo bueno es que tienes Spanish, clase de español, entonces no tienes que salir. It's really nice to have you here. Okay, people, I'm gonna be out of the screen for about like 10 minutes. I have to solve a problem with another student that can't join this lesson. So I'm gonna solve that really fast and then I come back. If you're just logging into this lesson, thank you for joining Living Spanish. Don't forget to like this class. If you're here for the class, let me know in the live chat. I'm gonna start really, really, really soon. Thank you so much for joining. Hi, Deborah. Really nice to have you here today. From which part of California are you writing us? Thank you so much for joining this class. Thank you to all the people that are joining. If you're here for the class, let me know in the live chat. We're gonna start in 5 minutes. Okay, when we have a little crowd to start. Northern California, how is the weather today in your city? Seventy-four. That's kind of hot. It's not cold actually. That's nice. That's really nice. It's a nice weather. Similar right now to Quito, Ecuador. We're really sunny today. It's kind of weird. Because usually Sundays are really cloudy and rainy. Thank you to all the people that are joining. If you're here for the class, let me know in the live chat. We're going to start in about 5-4 minutes when we have a little crowd to start. Don't forget to get comfortable in your house. Get your cup of coffee, tea, water, juice, whatever you want to drink, a piece of paper and pen if you need it. Don't forget that all the answers are submitted in the live chat. Okay? Topic of today, Dia de Muertos. We're going to talk about the celebration that is coming really soon, right, in most of the Latin American countries. Before we start the class, in 5 minutes, I will explain you how this class works, okay? How we're going to do the activities, the exercises, and how the answers are submitted. Until that, get comfortable. Don't forget to share this link with your friends, family, classmates. Everybody is really welcome in Living in Spanish. We do these classes every weekend. And today I'm not wearing my glasses. But no worries. I will wear them later to see your answers. Thank you to all the people that are joining. If you're here for the class, let me know in the live chat. Also, don't forget to follow me in Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter as Living in Spanish. I leave some of the link in the description of this video, of this live class. So go there, click, and follow me for more news. I upload videos every Tuesday in the afternoon around 4. So you will get notifications in your YouTube channel if you're a subscriber. Also, I announce at what time I'm starting these classes in my Instagram. So don't forget to follow me. Thank you to all the people that are joining. We're going to start really, really soon when we have a little crowd to start. Don't forget, topic of today, Dia de Muertos, Day of the Dead. I'll be right back. Let me check how is my student doing. Oh, sorry. Now you can hear me. I have my microphone off. Okay, so we're just waiting a little bit for my last student to connect. Okay, he's having a little problems. Let's wait a little bit, and then we can start with the lesson. Until that, don't forget to follow me in Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. McQueen, Día de los Muertos, sounds interesting. No sé mucho de este día. Solo que puedo ver en Coco. Exactly. Coco is a nice movie to talk about Día de Muertos, right? If you haven't watched Coco, you should watch it. It's a really nice one. Yes, exactly. Okay. That's what we're going to be talking about today. Okay, sorry everybody for making you wait more than normal. We're here and we're ready for the class. Okay, so before we start the class, I'm gonna explain a little bit how this class works. Okay, And just one thing before I start explaining, if you're ready for this class, say listo in the live chat, okay? I'm gonna wait for you to say listo in the live chat so we can start. And while you say listo, I'm gonna explain you how this class works. Luna, listo, perfecto. Thank you so much. Okay, so how this class works? We have three activities, okay? Activity number one, I'm gonna give you like the beginning of a sentence and you will have to complete that sentence with your own words. Don't forget that all the answers or sentences are submitted in the live chat, okay? So for each sentence, you will have a certain amount of time, okay? Activity number two, I'm gonna give you a sentence that is not in order and you will have to put it together, okay? Also, this sentence has a certain amount of time. And those sentences are also submitted in the live chat. Activity number three, I'm gonna give you a word. Also, for all my students, I already changed this activity number three, okay? So in the past, we used to do is like, I give you a word and you make a question or you make a sentence. Now, for this class, I'm gonna give you a word and you will have to make a question and the other students have to reply that question. Okay, we are gonna do it in turns. Everybody's gonna take a turn with the word, okay? And the other students will have to reply. If you have a question before we start, okay, you can make the question now. If you don't have a question, okay, we're going directly to activity number one. So thank you everybody for joining this class. Today we're gonna talk about Dia de Muertos. As you know, Dia de Muertos is a really popular celebration here in Latin America. It's really celebrated in places like Mexico and like in my country, Ecuador. But mostly all of the countries in Latin America celebrate this holiday, let's call it. Okay? Perfect. So let's start with activity number one, actividad número uno. Give me a second, let me get it ready. Okay, so activity number one, I'm gonna give you a sentence, okay, that is not completed. Yes, Chris, really nice to have you here. Perfect. You made it. Thank you so much for joining. Okay, so I was just going to explain how activity number one is gonna work. I'm gonna give you the beginning of a sentence, okay, and you will have to complete that sentence with your own words. When you completed the sentence, you submit your sentence in the live chat so I can review it. Perfect. Let's go with the sentence number one. Oración número uno. El día de muertos. El día de muertos. For this sentence, you have 1 minute. Starting now. Para esta oración tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Golden Door, that was really fast. 20 seconds, 20 segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno. Tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. I see everybody's typing really fast today. I like that, I like that, I like the speed. Golden Door, el día de muertos es en noviembre, ¿verdad? Exacto, día de muertos es en noviembre, los primeros días de noviembre, at least in Ecuador. I don't know about the other countries. Chris, El Día de Muertos es tomado en serio por mis vecinos. Yes, that's another good fact about Día de Muertos. Día de Muertos is a really important celebration in the Latin American culture. We take it really, really serious. Yeah, we like to like remember our dead. Okay, Luna. La gente visita el cementerio. Don't forget the spelling. Oh, sorry, I wrote wrong. Sorry. Okay, cementerio en el Día de Muertos. Exactly. That's the most popular day to visit cementerios. In Mexico, they do like an entire thing. They bring like band music. They eat in the cemeteries. They bring food to the dead people or to the dead members of their family. And they remember, they tell stories. It's a really, really beautiful celebration. In Ecuador, we have like really typical meals that we have in this day. We have colada morada, we have guaguas de pan, etc., etc. We also celebrate a little with food. Connie, el Día de Muertos es una tradición de origen prehispánico que se celebra en varios países de América Latina. Yes, I like that sentence, so complex, bien compleja. Exactly, it's a tradition. It has come from generation to generation. Everybody celebrates Day of the Dead directly or in an indirect way. McQueen. No celebremos el Día de Muertos. No celebramos. When you say no celebremos, you're calling to people to not celebrate. Okay? No celebramos el Día de Muertos en los Estados Unidos oficialmente. Pero me gusta la idea de esta tradición. I like your sentence. It's really, really complex. Perfect. Let's go to the sentence number two. Oración número dos. Los países que lo celebran. Los países que lo celebran. For this sentence, you have 1 minute starting now. Para esta oración, tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Yes, it's a little complicated. Doesn't have to be so complex. You can keep it simple. Thirty seconds, 30 segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Let me check them. Don't forget, funny sentences are allowed in this class. So if you want to make some joke there's no problem. Golden Door. Los países que lo celebran son, right? We can go directly to the verb. Ecuador y México. Perfect. Los países que lo celebran son. Okay, we already know that we're talking about Día de Muertos. That's why we use lo. Chris. Los países que lo celebran el Día de Muertos son países donde la iglesia también importa. This is a really interesting fact. Exactly. Most of these countries are Catholic countries. But not all the people are religious. Okay? In countries like Mexico, they like adore or bring tribute to the dead. They have a big dead culture there. So it's a little different. Let's wait a little bit for Connie before we pass to the next one. Okay, I guess we don't have another sentence, so let's go to the sentence number three, oración número tres. Un dato curioso sobre este día. Un dato curioso sobre este día. What is an interesting fact about this day? Okay, for this sentence you have 1 minute starting now. Para esta oración tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Thirty seconds, 30 segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos. Uno, tiempo. Time is up. Let me check your sentences. Luna. Un dato curioso sobre este día es que la gente dan comida a los muertos. Exactly. This is an interesting fact about this day. You make food for the living and for the dead. That's the common thing in this day. Really normal. Chris, un dato curioso sobre este día es mi barrio. En mi barrio es la dulce. El dulce es para los niños muertos. Exactly. Exactly. Also candies. They bring candies to the kids that have died. Exactly. And also, it's not just candy. They bring the favorite food that the person that is dead used to like when they were alive. So they bring their food to them. And sometimes they bring like big bands of music and they start playing music and they start telling stories. This is really interesting. Golden Door. Connie, no worries. After this one comes another one's more easy. And if you don't know anything about the grammar, just let me know. I can explain you really fast what the sentence means, okay? Perfect. Golden Door, un dato curioso sobre este día es que, don't forget preposiciones, hay 2 días separados, uno para los niños y otro para los adultos. Exactly, that's another interesting fact about this day, okay? It's really organized. Chris, Exactly. No, the local kids can't touch that. That's specifically for the dead. That food is well respected. Nobody touches. Okay, let's go to the next sentence. Sentence number four. Oración número cuatro. Sentence number four. Mi primer día de muertos. Mi primer día de muertos. So here in this sentence, you can tell us about you. How do you celebrate your first day of the dead? Or how will you celebrate it someday if you haven't done it yet? Okay? Perfect. For this sentence, you have 1 minute starting now. Para esta oración, tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Fifteen seconds, 15 segundos. Grace, allow you to speak today. Cinco, cuatro, tres. Dos, uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Chris, mi primer día de muertos fue realmente aterrador. I like that sentence. It's a perfect sentence. Why was aterrador, Chris? Let's wait a little bit for the other students. Luna, mi primer día de muertos, vi mucha gente vendiendo colada morada y pan en la forma de personas. That pan en forma de personas is called guaguas de pan. That's how it's called, guaguas de pan. Chris, porque no entendí. Yeah, in the beginning it's a little bit hard to understand that celebration. But you get used to it. And also grows on you. Okay, Golden Door. No he tenido mi primer día de muertos, pero me gustaría hacerlo en México. Exactly. In Mexico they do it like 1 entire week, I think. Yeah, they paint their faces. It's an entire festival, Day of the Dead. And they also get really happy and really emotional that week. So there is a nice celebration going on there. Connie, if it's too difficult for you, just let me know. I can make it a little easier for you. Let's go to sentence number five and also last sentence of activity number one. En este día recordamos. En este día recordamos. Okay, for this sentence, you have 1 minute starting now. Para esta oración, tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Okay, Connie, no worries. You can join in the activity number two. That's a little easier. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno. Tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Chris, en este día recordamos los que se han ido y perdido. Exactly. Can be friends, can be family, right? Somebody that you knew. We remember all those people. McQueen, en este día recordamos los muertos de la familia. Exactly. You tell the stories of how they used to be, what they used to like, what they didn't like, right? All the bad things about them, all the good things about them. So that's what you do in that day. Perfect. So let's go to, oh, I guess we have one more. Luna, en este día recordamos los buenos momentos de los muertos. Exactly. Here in these days where you say all those stories about them, the good and the bad ones. Okay, perfect. We're done with activity number one. Let's go to activity number two. Okay, for this activity, I'm gonna give you a sentence that is not in order. Okay, and you will have to put it together. For each sentence, you will have a different amount of time. Okay, for this second activity, also, all these sentences are common phrases that people use in Day of the Dead. Okay, some of these sentences are really popular sayings from people in this day. And I have a couple of my favorites that I put here. Saying that, let's go directly to activity number two. Sentence number one. Don't forget, a trick to complete these sentences or to put them together is to pay attention to the punctuation. Hay que poner atención a la puntuación. Mayúsculas, coma, punto final, punto seguido, etcétera, etcétera. That will help you to understand where the sentence begins and when it ends. Okay? Perfect. Saying that, let's go to sentence number one. Oración número uno. For this sentence, you have 3 minutes starting now. Para esta oración, tienen 3 minutos comenzando ahora. Dos minutos, 2 minutes. I like that speed, yes. Okay, so I'm gonna stop here the time. I see that everybody replied. Perfect, I like that speed. Connie. Solo los muertos han vivido el final de la guerra. Perfect. Chris, solo los muertos han vivido el final de la guerra. Good. Luna, solo los muertos de la guerra han vivido el final. ¿Qué significa? Okay, first, Let me send the correct sentence and then we talk about the meaning. So there we go. That's the correct sentence. Solo los muertos han vivido el final de la guerra. So what does it mean? The war never ends for the ones that are living, right? They still lost people, lost members in their families. And it's a clear message that war shouldn't happen, okay? That's all, the entire message. Solo los muertos han vivido el final de la guerra. Only the dead people have gotten to the end of the war. That's it, okay? Han visto, exactly. Han visto. We use han visto to indicate you have lived something, okay? For example, I ask you, has visto playing the Rolling Stones, right? Has vivido esa experiencia. Have you lived that experience? Have you, I don't know, right? Do you have the experience? You live it. Has visto. It's commonly used as an expression, not literal. Or also, it's like when you know something that anybody else knows. For example, like in this case, the dead know the end of the war, right? What is the end of the war in this case? Dead. Okay? Perfect. Let's go to the sentence number two, oración número dos. Since the other one you did it really fast, for this one you have 2 minutes starting now. Para esta oración tienen 2 minutos comenzando ahora. Un minuto. Chris, you're on fire today. I like it. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Connie, for the last one, yes, it was a spelling mistake of mine. Okay, han vivido. Okay, but also means the same. Sorry about that. Chris, vivir en los corazones que dejamos atrás no es morir. That's a nice sentence. I like it. Connie, vivir en que dejamos atrás los corazones no es morir. Let's wait a little bit for Luna and let's check. Until that, let me get ready the correct sentence. Okay, let's go with the correct sentence. Vivir en los corazones que dejamos atrás no es morir. Vivir en los corazones que dejamos atrás no es morir. Luna, good job. Perfect. Exactly. So what this means? It means that you never die when there are people that still love you and remember you. Okay, perfect. Let's go to the sentence number three. And this one is one of my favorites. Qué lindo. Yeah, it's a nice phrase. Okay. Perfect. For sentence number three, oración número tres. This one is a really easy one. So I'm going to give you 1 minute and 30 seconds for this one. Okay? 1 minute and 30 seconds starting now. 1 minuto y 30 segundos comenzando ahora. One minute, 1 minuto. Thirty seconds, 30 segundos. Okay, I'm gonna make a little pause here. There was a mistake in that sentence. Probably that's why it got a little difficult. Okay, so you have 1 extra minute starting now. 1 minuto extra comenzando ahora. I submitted the correction of that sentence. Thirty seconds, 30 segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos. Uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. This one is actually a classic phrase. Until that, let me get it ready. Chris, no estaba parranda, andaba de muerto. That's actually tragic. Connie, no estaba muerto, andaba de parranda. I like that sentence. Perfect, that's the right sentence. No estaba muerto, andaba de parranda. This actually is a classic one. What it means? It means, like, for example, let's say that your kid, right, went to party and he's partying for like 3 days, and after 3 days, he shows back in your house. So you say, oh, so no estaba muerto, estaba de parranda, right? He was not dead, he was just partying. Yeah, and like that, you can use it for sarcasm, you can use it in literary ways and things like that. When people get lost, most of the time, and they appear after 3 days, this is what they say: oh, no estaba muerto, estaba de parranda, right? So this is a really common used word or phrase. Perfect. Connie, really, really good job. Let's go to sentence number four, oración número cuatro. McQueen, thank you for asking. Yes, I also do private lessons for all those students and think they need reinforcement with their Spanish. Okay, I teach for this site called Italki. Okay, if you follow me in Instagram, I'm gonna leave my link in Instagram for my profile if you need private lessons. Okay, just go there, book the class that adapts to your needs, and I will see you there if you need private lessons. Thank you so much for asking, McQueen. Perfect. And if you need also more information, just write me a private message in Instagram, in Facebook, in Twitter, or here in YouTube, and I will be happy to answer all your questions. Okay, let's go to the next one. Sentence number four, oración número cuatro. Sentence number four. For this sentence, you have 2 minutes starting now. Para esta oración, tienen 2 minutos comenzando ahora. Un minuto. I forgot a word, but was not leaving. Okay, I'm gonna give you this word. Okay, that's a word. The word that is missing in the sentence. Sorry about that. Okay, so there is a correction for you have 30 extra seconds. Chris, you can correct it if you want. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Chris, la vida de los muertos, that was my bad, está en la memoria de los vivos. Perfect. There you go. The correction is really well. Luna, la vida de los muertos en la memoria de los vivos. I forgot that word. Yes, it's está. Perfect. Connie. La vida de los muertos está en la memoria de los vivos. Exactly. Every dead person lives in the memory of the ones they are alive. Okay. Let's go to this last sentence. Just let me double check it before I send it. Okay. Sentence number five, and also last sentence of activity number two. There we go. For this sentence, you have 2 minutes starting now. Para esta oración tienen 2 minutos comenzando ahora. Un minuto. Thirty seconds, 30 segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo. Let's check. Connie, el muerto al pozo y el vivo al gozo. Perfect, following the punctuation, I like it. Luna, el muerto al pozo y al gozo y el vivo. I like it. Chris, el muerto al gozo y el vivo al pozo. Pozo, what is pozo? You know, like in the old times when they used to make a hole in the air to collect water. That's a pozo. Okay? So the dead one to the hole and the living one to enjoy. Okay? That's literally what it means. Okay, I like Connie. Really, really nice sentence. I like it. Chris, also, really nice sentence. Luna, I can see that this expression is really new to you, but really good job. Perfect. Let's go to the next activity. Activity number three and also last activity of the class. Okay? I'm gonna explain you one more time how this is gonna work. I'm gonna give you a word, okay? And all of you will have to make a question, okay? I'm gonna start reading the questions in the order that you are sending it. And every one of you have to reply that question also, sending your own sentences in the live chat, okay? We're gonna do it. I'm gonna read them, okay? So I'm gonna send you the first word right now. Luna, suena como un brindis. Exactly. People use it a lot when they are drinking. Okay, perfect. So let's go with activity number 3. Question number 1. Muertos. You have to make a question with this one, submit it in the live chat, and then let's see, okay? So let's go. Muertos. For this question, you have 1 minute starting now. Para esta pregunta, tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Perfect. Quince segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno. Tiempo. Time is up. Connie, we're waiting for your question. Chris, this is the question number 1. Chris, ¿tú crees que los muertos viven en la ultratumba? That's a nice question. Okay, so everybody have to reply this question. ¿Crees que los muertos viven en la ultratumba? Sí, no, ¿por qué? Okay, let's reply Chris' question in the live chat. At your own peace, no worries. So, what is your personal experience? You think that the dead are living in the ultratumba? Why is ultratumba this place that they go after death, supposedly? I don't know. Okay. So, Luna, Connie, reply that question. Chris, you can also reply if you want. Reply your own question. I'm gonna wait 30 seconds for everybody to reply, starting now. Diez segundos. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo. Okay, let me see those answers. Chris, no, cuando mueres te pudres. Ha, so you don't believe in ultratumba. Let's see what Connie says. What Luna says. ¿Creen o no creen en la ultratumba? Luna, no sé dónde vamos, cuándo morimos. That's a big mystery of the life. Wait a couple more seconds. If not, we're going to the question number 2. which was from Luna. ¿Qué pasa a los muertos? ¿O qué pasa con los muertos? ¿Qué pasa con los muertos? I mean that you're trying to ask what happened with their body or where they go. Okay, so both answers are valid. So for this, to answer this question, you have 30 seconds starting now. ¿Qué pasa con los muertos? They go to heaven, they go to hell, they go to the limbo, I don't know. As Chris says, se pudren. What happened con los muertos? Twenty seconds. Ten seconds. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo. Chris, Connie, ¿qué pasa con los muertos? They died and that's it. They go to heaven, they go to hell. Chris, van a un hoyo en el suelo. Exactly. Luna, nadie sabe. Well, what Chris said makes a lot of sense to me. Okay. Let's go to the next question. Oh, this is a nice question, actually. I like it. Golden Door. ¿Crees que los muertos se regresan como fantasmas? You think the dead ones come back as ghosts? Okay. For this answer or reply of this question, you have 30 seconds starting now. 30 segundos desde ahora. Veinte segundos, 20 seconds. Ten seconds, 10 segundos. Cinco. Cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo, time is up. Let me see your sentences. Do you think the dead ones comes back as ghosts? ¿Crees que los muertos regresen como fantasmas? Sí creo, no creo. ¿Por qué? Let me see your answers. Chris, mi alma estará feliz de estar dormido. Exactly. We're actually gonna rest in peace. I'm not coming back as a ghost. Finally, I can sleep all day, so I won't take that chance away, right? Okay, let's see the other answers. If there is no other answers, we pass to the next question, Connie question. Golden Door. Sería chévere molestar a los vivos. Yeah, I think it would be really cool also to buy people just to get them scared a little bit. I like that. I like it. Okay. Let's go to Connie's question. ¿Cuándo es el día de los muertos? ¿Cuándo es el día de los muertos? For this sentence or for this answer, you have 30 seconds starting now. Tienen 30 segundos comenzando ahora. Ten seconds. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno. Tiempo. Time is up. Chris, el Día de Muertos es desde octubre 21 hasta noviembre 2. ¿Ok? Luna. 1 o 2 de noviembre, both are correct. In Central America, they celebrate from the 21 until the 2nd. And in Ecuador, from the 1st to the 2nd of November. Okay, we celebrate just 2 days. Okay, Connie, no lo sé, no worries. That's okay. So we finish with the first question. Let's go to the second one. We're gonna do three, so no worries. It's not gonna be that long. Celebración. Celebración. To make this question, you have 1 minute starting now. Para hacer esta pregunta, tienen 1 minuto comenzando ahora. Treinta segundos, 30 seconds. Cinco, cuatro. Tres, dos, uno, tiempo, time is up, tiempo, tiempo, tiempo. Let's check, let's wait a little bit for Connie and then we start checking. Okay, Chris. ¿Es la muerte algo para celebrar? ¿Es la muerte algo para celebrar? Is that something that you should celebrate? Okay, that's the question. To reply this question, you have 30 seconds starting now. Para responder esta pregunta, tienes 30 segundos. Chris, no, quiero vivir para siempre. Exactly. Ser inmortal. I like that. Let's wait a little bit for another answer. If no, we pass to the next one. Luna, creo que es bueno celebrar la vida de los muertos, pero el muerto siempre es triste. Exacto, la muerte siempre es triste. Eso es verdad. That's really, really true. That is always sad. Perfect. Next question. ¿Cuál es tu celebración favorita? ¿Cuál es tu celebración favorita? Okay, to reply this question, you also have 30 seconds starting now. Para esto tienen 30 segundos comenzando ahora. Ten seconds. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo. Okay, Chris, acción de gracias, no iglesia, no regalos, solo comida y bebidas. I like that. Exactly. That's a nice celebration also. Acción de gracias. A lot of food, especially turkey. Okay. Mine personal is Carnaval and Thanksgiving. Those are my favorites. Let's wait a little bit for another response. If not, we go to the last one. To the last question, let me get ready. Okay, so next one. Luna, me gusta Navidad. Okay, perfect. Christmas is a really good one. Let's go to the last question. Latinoamérica. Latinoamérica. Okay, to make this question, you have 1 minute starting now. And that's the last one of the day. Latinoamérica. 1 minute starting now. Twenty seconds. Cinco, cuatro, tres, dos, uno, tiempo. ¿Te gustaría visitar Latinoamérica? Primera pregunta. Let's wait for Chris. Let's wait for another questions. Okay, so to reply this question, you have 30 seconds starting now. Para responder a esta pregunta, tienes 30 segundos comenzando ahora. Chris, ¿qué tipo de comida tendríamos sin Latinoamérica? I like that one. Okay, 30 seconds to reply these two questions. Okay, you start now. 30 seconds. Okay, 30 seconds to reply these two questions. Okay, starting now.